Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining us so early. Very exciting spaces today. We're going to give a couple more minutes for our panelists to join. I already see HBAR Joe there. We're going to wait for Hashpack and Earthlings to join as well. And very excited to talk to you guys today about the upcoming INOs and some of the biggest events in Hedera history when it comes to the retail-facing applications that we came to know and love. I would like to first hand it off to May. It's the first spaces that I think we do in forever. And you guys have been rolling out some amazing stuff. I'm sure that it's been a very complex time with a lot of developments. But overall, May, how do you feel and how has 2024 started for you?
I would say that 2024 has been the best start to a year that we've seen since even like before 2020. The energy in Hedera is extremely high. People are really bullish on a lot of the things that are happening. We're seeing a lot of growth. We're seeing a lot of liquidity coming into the ecosystem. It's looking to be a really, really good time for the network.
I couldn't agree more. And you guys have been as busy as ever. How's the team dealing with the workload so far?
We're just pumping away. It's really challenging to be a small team and have a lot of things that we want to do, a lot of projects that we want to collaborate, and yet having limited time, limited resources. So it is going to get even busier as this year progresses, and we're just really looking forward to all the things that we're going to be doing.
Yeah, you guys definitely give a helping hand, and you're an important pillar for the community, whether it's the retail adoption stage or also the development stage projects. Obviously, you guys play a big role, and I'm sure that everybody, they if they launch in Hedera, they at least peer with you guys at some point. So kudos for staying lean over the bear market and turning a new tide. Now, obviously, May, Hashpack is doing their INO, and you guys have been ramping up for this event for some time. How would you quantify this INO when it comes to the magnitude of the developments that you guys have been rolling out over the past few years?
So I think that INO is our next step in sort of engaging with the community and basically giving us more tools to do what we've been doing this whole time. So as a wallet, we see ourselves as the interface to Hedera. So if you want to come onto Hedera and do something, we are that first step, right? We have a dApp browser that lets you connect to all the major dApps that are in the ecosystem, and we're adding more every time someone new comes in. We want to push them and give them the spotlight and let them access the users that are on Hedera and let the users know about what they're doing. That has been sort of our game plan for this whole time is like, how do we engage the community? How do we get people to know about projects and get them excited and get them to look at things? And I think that with PAC token that is coming out that we've been working on since the beginning of the year, even before that, we're going to be having the tools that we can use to even make this even more engaging. And basically, we see this INO, we see this PAC token as a way of boosting the ecosystem, of getting people coming in who haven't heard of Hedera before, who haven't experienced DeFi in our ecosystem, and sort of incentivizing them to come and try things out.
Okay, yeah, certainly that's very well put. And we all know how important when it comes to the adoption of a certain layer one network, when it comes to the overall awareness how important a token is. Would you say that the PAC token and the INO are something that are crucial in the up and coming phase of awareness when it comes to adoption of Hedera at large?
Yeah, I think that as one of the leaders in the space, one of the first leaders, I suppose, in the space, Hashpack and PAC token have a really good chance to bring some excitement and bring some attention to the ecosystem. And I think that that's just the start. I'm definitely looking forward to all these other projects that are coming in and building their tokens, whether they're meme tokens or whether they're real utility or whether they're enterprise tokens. I think they all have a place in this ecosystem as we grow. Something like PAC token, something like Sauce, or even Steam with Earthlings, these are all utility tokens that have a lot of development behind them. So they take a bit of time to come in. And when they do start delivering on their value proposition, they generate a lot of value for the ecosystem. And that's great, but it takes time to build those in. And one of the things we want to do is encourage more builders to come in and launch those utility tokens. On the flip side, we have meme tokens, which are really fast to come out. Their product velocity is really high. And that's really important too, because driving in hype, driving in engagement is one of the big things that that we need to do as a DeFi ecosystem going into this next bull market. And, you know, meme tokens are seen as silly and kind of, you know, maybe not in the best light, especially if you're more on the enterprise side of Hedera. But I think it's really important to embrace the idea that these kind of fun and fast to launch projects are also part of a really important, a really important part of this ecosystem to drive more value, to drive more engagement, and to get that sort of space running so that these utility projects can succeed. And then even further down the roadmap are enterprise use cases, which are slow to come out, but they have immense amount of value. And those will come on the tails of meme tokens and utility projects. And I think they're all part of this ecosystem. And we should all recognize that all of them are a really important part of what we're doing here.
There's a lot to unpack there, May, but I couldn't agree more. You touched on a few very, very important things when it comes to the overall cohesiveness of the ecosystem and how over the past few years, Hashpack, Earthlings, Headstarter, Sauce, all the other projects that have been here for some time have been contributing to creating this snowball effect where we are right now at the point where we can say that there is this velocity in new meme tokens that are being created, and all of them carry a lot of importance in raising awareness, displaying the unique value proposition, displaying the cohesiveness of the space, and making a stand, as you said. If it isn't for these projects that of early trailblazers in the Hedera ecosystem, likely even the last phase that you mentioned, which is the enterprise adoption, doesn't then push as quickly as it would otherwise, right? But I know that I've kept Patrick waiting for a long time. I know it's difficult for him. So Patrick, thank you so much for joining us. And would you like to segue in any way from May's thoughts into how you feel Earthlings and Steam have positioned themselves over the past year in engaging with the community and leading to this INO and token generation event?
Sorry, what did you just say? Tudor, man. These long sentences. I want to segue back to May, because it's been like 2 years since, not 2 years yet, but almost since I've been in a space with May. It was the first space where she saved me from saying more stupid things than I usually already do, but I blacked out and it was May to the rescue. May, I never forgot that, and I'm telling the world always. So that's the first way where I wanted to go sideways. But I've got no clue how to answer that long sentence you just said. But we're happy building here, and exciting things are happening now, as you know as well, because we're building a lot. But now you going towards the INO and the IDO, it's an amazing time. And if you could make your question a little shorter, a little bit more in detail what you want to hear, or else I'll pass it to Joe, my smarter second half of the team, and he can answer all these long questions.
I love you, Patrick.
yes. So I love you too. So that was an easy one.
Joey, do you have any thoughts on how Steam Token and your overall community engagement over the past few years with the awesome utility NFTs that you've been rolling to the community engagement, contributing to point we are today in the Hedera ecosystem, where we have a lot more visibility, there's a lot more excitement, and a lot of we've seen quite some influx of new users and community members?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we're a perfect example of why community is everything. You know, they've funded us, we're completely funded by the community so far. It's driven from day one with our founders cards being launched, which was a big, well, let's hope people like it, to going with airships and then doing giveaways and creating a fun token to test a mint process and having that pin go out. And then the next thing you know, people are in the community are buying and selling these pins for thousands of dollars, which came totally unexpected. And then you start to see things revive after the NFT surge. We start to come back and see, like May said, 2024 started off with a bang. And you see projects getting reach outside of Hedera, like Karate Combat with 100,000 people, 100,000 different wallets holding Karate, and then 4,000 with their ERC 20 token. And you see the reach starting to move outside of Hedera, but it's the internal community that's supported us. And with our upcoming INO, we took a little different track on it. We want to stay true to our NFTs, where if we give something that's not free as of right now, we want to make sure it's rare, so it's a real collectible, or it has a whole lot of utility. So we didn't expand our INO quite as much as we wanted to. There are 750 opportunities there for INO purchases. So that's not a ton in the grand scheme of things. We price tiered it, but we really wanted to make sure that our core community from the start was guaranteed an opportunity to participate on some level, and then to open it up outside of that. And we want to make sure that Steam isn't something that people are just getting for hype and here today, gone tomorrow. We really want to build that value in long term. As we build, as we release mobile games, as we launch things on marketplaces and have the opportunity to use our Steam token inside businesses like Syntex and some really, really cool ideas we have coming up that we can't announce yet with some of the top projects that we haven't truly announced a partnership with. So that's the thing that the community's been able to give to us. And we thank everyone from the bottom of our heart. And we're so amazed that 32,000 wallets have associated our bag holder NFT and received or are going to receive a PH Steam drop, and even more ultimately will receive Steam because of that. We want those people to see what we're doing, watch where we go, and see what we're going to provide in value with our Steam token, as opposed to just, oh, we're a game, so we need to sell a token.
I think that you guys, out of everybody, have not gone that route of we're a game, we're selling a token. I think in terms of community engagement and just like reaching out and having a way for people to talk to you and be involved as you develop this game, I think you guys have done a bang up job. And I just want to say kudos to your team. You really put an effort into talking to people and making the community feel like they are part of your project. And I think that's really important here in Hedera. We have that sort of culture of collaboration that I really, really think is special in the Web3 space.
Thank you, May. And we just left a space where we were talking about that. You know, we're family friendly. And if you think about it, Hashpack's family friendly, right? It's for everyone. With Earthlings, we want parents to be able to leave their 9-year-old kid playing the game without them standing over their shoulder worrying about wallets and volatility and liquidity pools and losing money that they've put into the game because the token changed values. So we have to attack it from all angles. And yes, Steam will have liquidity, and we anticipate and hope it's very successful. But if we want parents to enjoy Earthlings with their children, we have to make a fun, enjoyable way that they can play and their kids can play without having to worry about how to load a wallet and how to trade tokens. So with our off-chain token water, it's going to be fun, and just like any Web2 mobile or PC game now that people are playing. But we want to bring those two groups from opposite ends of the spectrum to meet somewhere, not necessarily in the middle, but to meet somewhere so that those bubbles, those two independent bubbles, turn into one and people get comfortable with using Web3 wallets and NFTs and how to buy and sell your NFT and how to trade tokens. And that takes time, and that takes being forward with your community. If I take Earthlings to my nephew's birthday party once we launch, and I'm trying to teach his friend's parents about the game, I don't want to teach them about Web3. I want to teach them how fun our game is, and how if they do put money into the game for their child, that they can get something back out of it. And that's our whole goal, right, is to make that happen for people that hasn't happened yet in gaming.
Thank you very much for that, guys. And you're getting me a bit nostalgic here when I think about how far we've come over the past 2 years, and you definitely are prime examples of projects that are walking the talk. And you mentioned a bit earlier about the metrics that you've seen in terms of your adoption, Joey. Could you tell us a bit more about the airdrop that you recently have and had, and the wallets that now hold the token?
Yes. So I'll actually, we've got two things up top. I'll put that up top as well. So we started an idea. And I'll be honest, I'm a huge fan personally. We're not partnered as a brand with Karate Combat by any stretch. They're a combat sport, young, wild, fun experience, which I really enjoy. But what I have learned from them is how to grow the community. And like I said, they taught me that giving back to the community so people will take advantage of what you're offering and come in and learn more about your product. So what we did is we were talking to Brandon, the HBAR Bull, and he said, you know, it would be really cool if some Hedera projects, some quality Hedera projects would do an airdrop for HBAR holders. You know, we've done projects or we've done airdrops for if you hold this NFT or this other NFT or this brand, we'll give you some tokens. But what about everybody that's stuck around in the HBAR community since day one? So kind of went to the drawing board, and Patrick and I thought, well, you know, what if we create a cool NFT around it and come up with an awesome campaign where anybody can associate our bag holder NFT, our PH theme, which is just a placeholder for our regular Steam until it comes out, and associate our Steam, then we could do periodic surprise airdrops. And what we decided was if we divided it over 4 months, we could give it away in increasing increments so that as more people found out about it, the drop wouldn't necessarily diminish to almost nothing. So that's what we decided. And then a couple of months ago, I said, Patrick, what if we have a leather bag falling out of the sky? And I figured it'd take him a week or two to put something together. And the next day, he had this amazing visual and started working on the actual videos for it and the clips. So our first one, we put it out, and I think in 2 weeks, we had 27,000 wallets associate our bag, our PH Steam, and our Steam token. So the first round, we did the surprise drop on the very last day of February. It was a 2 million PH Steam drop. And when you think about drops, you know, you see on Twitter, we're giving away to the next person that likes our tweet, we're giving away 140 million tokens. But then what you realize is the supply is 375 billion tokens. So it's really, really nothing. With our PH Steam and Steam campaign, we're giving away 1.5% of our total supply. We're giving away 15 million Steam. We're halfway through March. We haven't done the surprise snapshot for March. It's coming. So we hope that we get some more. I think we're up to 32,000 people or wallets associated now. So what that's done in term for metrics, it's increased our X following by more than 20%, our Discord engagement our Discord participation and members are up over 20%. We have 2.5-3 more months of this campaign, so we're hoping that as more and more people come in, it'll start to increase exponentially. And one thing that we've hinted at, but I haven't finalized the details on, for everyone, we're trying to grow our Telegram. For everyone that joins the Earthlink Telegram, I can promise you that there's going to be a bonus percentage of PH Steam dropped to you for holding the NFT and the PH Steam from our big airdrop. If you join our Telegram, you're going to get even more. And that's all I can say about that right now.
Thank you very much for the alpha. And wow, those are huge metrics when it comes to the distribution of the token already by any standards, including the most popular ETH projects and others. So kudos for that. And one thing that I would say that for me hit the radar a lot was as some of you people who have been in Hedera for a longer period of time know, one of the things that really probably was a not so happy moment was the fact that throughout 2021, the first result when you looked on YouTube for Hedera was the video from Coin Bureau, which didn't have the most positive review of Hedera as a layer one network. And we've had since then announcements of new council members, record after record when it comes to TPS and throughput and technological advancements, retail adoption, all these huge milestones that we've crossed over the past years, advent of DeFi, didn't come on the radar publicly from Coin Bureau, but what did was the fact that you guys did your airdrop. And as amazing as these metrics are when it comes to adoption and the overall growth, I think that there's no person that has a better view of the growth that we're seeing in the Hedera ecosystem than May. So May, I hope that I don't put you on the spot now asking you, what do you see when it comes to wallet creation, when it comes to the overall adoption? Because when you started, I think the number of account IDs on Hedera was below 500,000, yep. Right? So you've been at the forefront of all of this. So could you tell us a bit more about what you've seen over the past years, what you're seeing in terms of metrics and adoption?
Sure. I think that in the past, and I love that blast of the past from the Coin Bureau YouTube. I think the community back then, which was really small, we were all like, why is this a thing? Why are people so critical of it? Don't they see the excitement that's happening in the ecosystem? Why do they have to focus on things that aren't even really that true? And now we're in the point where people are, the positive stuff that's flowing out of the community is actually starting to take hold, and that's great. Back in the day, we used account creations as a metric to judge whether the ecosystem was going up. We used TPS as a metric as well. And I think that those are really kind of not the most accurate way of judging how the network is running now, because account creates are so cheap, and lots of projects just make them and they can boast that they made a million accounts or something like that. But then how many of those are users that are actually using the platform, and how many are active, and what is the actual value of those accounts? So gross numbers of accounts, I think, is not a great way of looking at it. Same with TPS, strangely enough, because we've actually just knocked that out of the park so well with over 1,000 TPS just constantly. And a lot of that has to do with Atma.io and our enterprise use cases. And that's very important, not from a network success perspective, but from a network performance perspective. And just to show that Hedera at extremely high TPS is outperforming pretty much every other layer one. And that's what we expected, because that's what Hedera strove to do when they built the ecosystem or built the platform. So like, these are things that I think we just can take for granted now because we've seen so much success over the past 2 years. In terms of actual growth though, I think that we can look at the rise of liquidity on, say, SaucerSwap. We had a doubling of TVL from December to January this year. And then up to now, so from February to now, a month, we've doubled that again. So that's a 400% increase in TVL on SaucerSwap, which is the main DEX on the ecosystem. And also from the wallet side, we're also seeing 400% more volume in terms of DeFi activity, and that's dollars traded on the platform. So we're seeing a proportional amount of people who are using the ecosystem. And that's huge. Like, this is not a small number. This is millions and millions of dollars that is now coming through the ecosystem that is showing that we as an ecosystem are growing and that we're growing very, very quickly. And I think that that's amazing. And then you can look at the stats for how many meme tokens are launching every single day, how many NFT projects are coming out, and those numbers are all up. So I think that just overall, we're seeing that Hedera is really starting to hit its stride and that we're not going to slow down. So, yeah.
Yeah, that's 100%, May. I really love the fact that you put an emphasis on the actual value, not only represented on chain, but the actual value that is locked. And we've seen over the past 2 years stay there. After that, saucer swap that are contributing a lot to this DVL. And to the people that have seen some of the decks that we have been communicating, we've been highlighting this discrepancy overall when it comes to the market cap of Hedera as layer one versus the market cap of the tokens that are circulating on Hedera, and also the market cap of Hedera versus its TVL. And we've been saying for more than 1 year now that being involved in a Hedera as a builder, as a contributor to liquidity, to as a holder of these tokens, represents an asymmetric opportunity, because if Hedera continues to develop in adoption in technology, it's only reasonable and it makes 100% sense that both the TVL on Hedera will grow at least to the mean when it comes to the other competitor layer ones, your Solanas of the world and ETH layer twos, etc. And also proportionally so will the projects with that have a fungible token that contribute to the market cap of these fungible tokens. And this will happen either through the growth of the market cap of the existing projects that have a circulating fungible token, or through new projects that will be launching. So I'm very excited, you know, to continue to see familiar faces in our spaces over the next few years and say that, okay, this person has been an OG and he had access to an asymmetric opportunity by being early in the growth of Hedera from the ground up. Because we have been building this space from the start of smart contracts 2.0, and it's been an amazing ride so far. Now, obviously, guys, we want this the spaces to be interactive, and I'm gonna go right next to the two panelists, Hashpack and Earthlings, to tell us a bit more about their INO, the rollout, and some of the things that we should look out for when it comes to their the release of their non-fungible token utility and also the fungible token. But before that, I want to invite everybody, if you have any questions for our amazing panelists today, feel free to request and I'll have you up on stage. I'm going to go first to Patrick, because I didn't hear him in a long time. Patrick, would you like to tell us a bit more about your upcoming INOs? What should we look out for?
Yeah, I'm going to explain it simple, because you know what they say, Tudor, if you can't ask it in a simple way, you actually don't understand it yourself. Yeah, that's what smart people say. You make these page-long questions. Anyway, so our INO is coming up, as everyone knows, and we did put something on top here. Yeah, so the INO is actually quite simple. So if you are eligible to join with all of your stuff, because you have a whole list of things with us, we'll make it simple, and Joey will probably add something to it, because I think something changed this afternoon, but I'm not sure. I'll let that up to Joey, because he's more in charge of this section as well. But it's if you are eligible, you can mint the bundle round first, and that means a discount on rounds three. So there's actually three rounds, 1, 2, and 3. With the first one, you can get a cabin or a barge, and that's randomly, so you don't know what you're gonna get, so that's always nice for surprise. Then with the second round, you can get one of the unique avatars that we are already minting now, and they will be very limited. And with the third round, that is also the least expensive one, you can get the special edition mono wheels. But if you do the bundle round on day one, you get a discount, so actually you get round three for free. So it's actually as easy as that. So it's 2 days, and I'm not able to mint, or no, not allowed to mint, and that was Joey's idea, but he excluded himself as well, the bundle round, because I really want a barge or a cabin, because yes, I am actually also a fan of my own project. My wallet is stuffed actually with bought items that I bought myself from our project. But I'm excluded from that round, so if there is anything left over the next day, I'll go for the golden a card where I can still get the barge or the cabin. If not, I'll want to have one of these avatars or monowheels. Yeah, but it's as simple as that. If you want to look up how you are eligible for minting, just go to the tweet and there's a whole list, or go to the Headstarter website, of course, where it's all also explained in detail. The tweets are, no, the posts, I need to say now, are more simple because, Tudor, also your pages are like super long. If you just go to the post, then you'll see all the information there. So, Joey, did I took quite long, but I used simple words so everyone understands. Joey, did I miss anything?
No. And there is a lot of information on the process and the fact sheet. So I would highly recommend for people to click on the link up top and just look at a copy of the fact sheet. It's a first round is a bundle round. There are specific qualifications for that. There's a snapshot on March the 18th, and the round will be live for only 2 hours on the 19th. Second round opens on the 20th, and there's a whitelist for that. You can see the details in the fact sheet. That's only 2 hours, and then one hour, and then immediately following will roll into the public round for 48 hours if there are any of those NFTs left. We anticipate a good crowd. We want everyone that's eligible to jump in and participate. The token amounts are there. If you can participate in the bundle and it's in your budget and you're looking to get a substantial amount of tokens through via Earthlings, and you like the NFTs and you've been waiting on that cabin or barge to be released, it is a good discount in that bundle round, and you get a little added bonus on the tokens and a little discount. So that's really important if you're planning on getting all three NFTs anyway. Take a look at that bundle round to start the process on the 19th. Otherwise, I'm not going to give a 20-minute explanation of each round and all of the NFTs. You did a good job with that, and I'll pass it back.
Yeah, it's actually, if you look at the fact sheet, if you look at the fact sheet, then it might look like a lot of information, but really, if you sit down and just read from top to bottom, it's just like a 2-minute read, and it's not that complex, but we tried to really sum it up as much as possible. But these things, if you have a first look at it, always look a little complex, but really it's quite simple. One bundle round and the rest in three rounds, separate rounds on the next day. That's it.
Thank you very much for the explanation, gentlemen. So if I were to sum it up, on the 19th at 2 p.m. UTC, there is the bundle round where you buy one bundle NFT and you receive six airdrops, which six NFTs as an airdrop, which represent the entire set of utility NFTs part of this INO. And for whatever NFTs are not minted part of the bundle round, they will go into the open round that launches 24 hours from that time at 2 p.m. UTC on the 20th of March. And for that round, there is an allow list that is still open for almost 6 hours. So there's 6 hours left to get up on the allow list for the open round. Yes, George.
One thing that is a late addition for many of you that may have already read the fact sheet in days before, for the whitelist round on the 20th, we did just today add the 100 Hashbash Earthlings NFTs in there as a qualifier for the whitelist. So if you have those or you've been looking at those, on that card it says eligible for pre-sale, and we didn't want to exclude people in parts of the world that can't participate in an IDO down the road. So we included those Hashbash Earthlings NFTs. There are four different styles of the Hashbash NFTs. This is specifically for the 100 of those that have Earthlings on them.
Yeah, thank you very much. That's a very important event that we did last year, and we hope to have a Hash Bash Volume 2 pretty soon. So Earthlings have included in the open round as a default guaranteed pass for the allow list set to participate in the open round, also the holders of the Hash Bash NFT. And that NFT will continue to enable participation in the public IDO that Earthlings might tell us a bit more about in the next few minutes. I'm gonna go to May real quick because the NFTs that Hashpack is launching right now in their INO are there's a lot to digest, and they're highly anticipated by everybody. And I also would like you, May, to tell us a bit more about how the past NFT collections have performed and what's their utility going forward. But first, we have Celestial being up and would like to say hello. Hey, thanks for joining us.
Hey guys, so just two questions. I think on the token card for the Steam tokens, do you have to wait at 6 months? I think it's like if you burn it early, you get half, right? If you wait for 6 months, you get the full amount. That's the face value of the token. And then for me, I know your project with the pack token, lots of utility coming, and I'm looking forward to that as well. So kudos to you and the team.
Yeah, good question. So there's a couple of things. Founders card holders are going to receive some Steam token NFTs that they can burn or hold. So some people have gotten confused with the INO NFTs. Let's talk specifically about the INO NFTs. You'll receive an NFT that you will exchange for the start time on your token distribution. So if you have that NFT and you don't burn it, you'll be able to trade it if you like. Once you burn that token, it'll start the clock on the way you receive your future Steam token. So you'll receive half when you burn it, and then you'll claim those through Headstarter, and then you'll wait 6 months and be able to claim the second half. Just like if anybody had or has the Headstarter tokens, there are still tokens out there that haven't been taken to the burn page, so you can sell those on the open market to anyone. But if you burn it, then those additional tokens aren't released until 6 months after your burn date. So there are multiple options. If you receive the NFTs, you don't immediately have to trade it in for Steam tokens. You can wait to any point you like, or you can sell it day one. So that those are the options with those NFTs.
Thanks a lot for the question, Celestial Being. If you go to the portfolio page on Headstarter, you hold any of our utility NFTs, you'll be able to see them over there. And should you choose to burn one of the utility NFTs, they have a similar functionality as you can expect for the Earthlings INO burnable NFTs, because once you burn the NFT, the token release vests according to the release metric. So a very exciting feature that I'm looking forward to having some other projects that you may know implement going forward. And I'm not encouraging burning of Headstarter utility NFTs. As you know, the exclusive ones, which are the most rare and only 9 in circulation to date, allow for guaranteed allocation in all the upcoming events on Headstarter. May, sorry for keeping you waiting for so long. Would you like to tell us a bit more about what we are to expect from your upcoming
event? Yeah, absolutely. I'll have to keep it short because I have to leave right on the hour. I've got to go across the border to do another speaking thing live tonight, and that's going to be a 3-hour drive. So I only have until the hour, but I'll keep it very simple as well. The INO for our concierge collectibles, that's a set of three. They look like little luggages on a podium. That's going to be sold inside of Hashpack in the store. So all you have to do is open up your Hashpack and hit store. And there will be an update coming real, real soon to the wallet that will add the cards to the store so that you can see that it's coming. There will be a countdown. And it's actually a very easy process to purchase the INO. You have an option of buying one of the three tiers. They are also going to be an option for buying a full set. And if you hold a full set at the end of the INO sale period, then you will get a kind of a bonus fourth NFT, which is all three of them together. So that's your bonus for having a full set. And that will come when the sale closes. We haven't set a date for that, but we also don't think that it will last that long. So basically, all you got to do is log into your Hashpack. If you have HBAR, then you can purchase the NFTs. And that will basically, if you hold those NFTs when the sale is over, when the token launches, you will get your airdrop based on what you get. Tudor, you also mentioned that we have NFTs that are also part of the pack airdrop that is coming. So the INO isn't the only way of getting pack token at the Genesis event. Although it is the main way, you get the best value for it in a sense. You also have the ability to just get an airdrop by having one of the Hashpack NFTs that we've launched in the past. And on our Twitter, there is a list of them. It includes our themes. It includes the hackathon coin that we did a while ago. It includes some of the collaborations that we've done. So check out that post on our Twitter to see if you've got an eligible Hashpack NFT. And if you do, then all you got to do is associate the Hashpack token, and then you will just get an airdrop and you don't have to participate in the INO. So that's just a additional reward for people who have supported us for all this time. If you want more information on the INO, it's at hashpack.app/token, or you just go to our website and there's a token header in the menu bar and it'll have all the information there. You just have to go into the store and click on the thing when the sale goes live, and easy, easy peasy. We did our first test, not first test, we did our like main test as like everybody in the team piling into a room and trying it out yesterday. And it was really, really good. It was really smooth. Pluto has done a great job of the interface. So hopefully everybody will have a good time. And yeah, you don't have to have anything special to participate in the INO. We have no like whitelist, or we have no requirements to participate. Everyone gets a fair chance at getting this INO. We even have a captcha there so that we stop bots from coming in and trying to take up things. So hopefully everybody that participates is a real person. That's the idea. So yeah, everyone gets a fair share. We didn't do a pre-sale or anything like that. No over-the-counter deals or under-the-counter deals. This is going to be a really, really fun one.
Thank you very much, May. And what better way to distribute your INO than having it open for everybody, as you have been for years as the gateway drug into the Hedera ecosystem. One question that will arise, and I would like to ask you real quick, you mentioned that there will be an additional NFT should you have all three of them. Does this NFT compound based on how many sets you have? And is there a snapshot after the mint that will determine how many of these NFTs you will receive, or is it based on the mint amount?
It's based on if you hold it. So basically, if you participate in the INO, hold on to that your sets until you actually get the airdrop of the bonus token and also the pack tokens. There will be plenty of time before the snapshot of the sets for people to realize to have it in their their accounts. But to keep it simple, just make sure that you have the full sets in that single account, and then you'll get the drop for sure. If you guys have participated in the past in the sausage swap INO, it's basically the same thing. It is a flat bonus of tokens per set that you own. So it's not a, I mean, you could see it as a multiplier, but really it's just like every set that you have, you get, I think it's in there, I think it's 6,000 extra tokens. That is going to be very clear on the store when you go in and make the purchase, and you'll see it's right there how much you're going to get. And of course, all the other utilities that come with the collectibles will happen as well. For example, one of the things that we're doing with Dovu is that if you stake Dovu on their platform and you have a concierge collectible, you will get a bonus in your staking rewards. And if you have the full set, you will get that set NFT, and that set NFT will give you additional rewards on top of what other concierge collectibles get. So there's benefits to having them. And we're working with other projects to add more utilities to these NFTs. And the idea is that we want people to benefit from being part of our user base and being part of the community and participating in what this community has to offer.
Thank you very much for that, mate. I'm going to squeeze one more question out of you. You're going to have the INO pretty soon in the next few weeks, as far as we understand. What should we expect when it comes to the distribution of the PAC token?
The PAC tokenomics are all in the light paper, and I think it's fairly clear what's going to, like, where everything is being allocated. So if you go to hashpack.app/token, there's a link to the light paper, and it'll have all of that distribution out there. And so then you guys can look at that before you participate in the INO. That I think is pretty clear. The other question, sorry. It wasn't a question, but you said that the INO will be in the next few weeks. I'll just leak it here because we're about to announce it maybe today or tomorrow. But the INO, we're going to plan to have it happen this Sunday. So make sure you guys update your Hashpack wallets. Make sure you keep an eye out on our announcements on our Twitter platform. Our Twitter account, sorry, we'll be announcing it officially pretty soon here, I think. And I hope I don't get hung by my team for saying this, but it is on Sunday, so that's only a few days from now. Keep your eyes peeled.
Wow, totally got blindsided by that. Thank you, May, and appreciate you sharing the exclusive alpha with us.
We will defend you. Patrick? We will defend you, May, if they complain, okay?
I will appreciate it. Yeah. We'll have you over. You can guard the doors so that they don't beat down for saying this.
Age barbarians at the gate, right? Patrick? Hashpack have made it very easy with their INO.
Is someone muted? Tudor? I think he's... Tudor? You still there? No. It's all good, Tudor.
Could you tell us, Patrick, a bit more about what we can expect for the Steam token after the INO?
After the INO, we're going to go for the IDO, of course, that's coming around the corner as well. And we're looking at listings on exchanges. So, and of course, after the INO, we're not going to sit still. We're going to build a lot more as well. And we're already actually growing the team even before the IDO INO. So, don't know if you have any specific things in mind, but we're not going to sit still. And we have a lot coming out this year. Also, by the way, that's something that I'm working on a lot, because we want to do more with cinematic trailers and trying to push more regular content on that site out as well to just do a little more marketing because we really love what we are building ourselves as well. And we have amazing sceneries. And I thought, well, it would be cool if we can show that on a regular basis and do more promotion on maybe on TikTok, but also on YouTube, on separate channels there. So yeah, we're going to, and not of course only doing cinematics, we're really growing the team, going towards 30 already. So yeah, we're not sitting still. Lots happening, but Joey's always better at explaining these in little nice roadmaps because I'm better at writing things out and preparing these things than just on the spot say what we're working on. And as you know, I always speak about what I worked on that day. And lately, I'm working a lot on cinematics. So anyway, lots happening.
So we'll have the IDO fact sheet that looks similar to the INO fact sheet. We'll have that out hopefully in the next couple of days before, it'll be out before the INO on Tuesday, so people will be able to take a look at that and make some decisions. I think they're both very fair and fun and interesting ways to participate in our Steam token launch. So not every single detail for the IDO will be on there, but most of the important ones to make decisions as a consumer.
Thank you very much for the full context, guys. I'm very happy that I managed to catch all three of you guys for this spaces. And I know you're tight on time, so we're going to wrap it up now. If there's any... anybody who has any questions for our panelists and the exciting events that they have lined up, please feel free to reach out to them over their channels. You know, they're always available, but be careful for scammers. Be careful as we continue to grow this ecosystem of retail-facing application and get more users, more TVL, more token activity and token velocity on chain, you're going to continue to see more scam attempts. So always stay vigilant. I'm very happy and excited to see Earthlings and Hashpack take the next step in their mission towards that it has been Hedera-centric for the past 2 years, and they have been walking the talk all this time, building this whole thing from the ground up and creating network effects along the way. So make sure that you go and support the Hashpack on 12th, which is Sunday, as they launch their INO, and also thereafter. Please follow on the events that Earthlings are doing, which is their bundle INO and Steam INO, and following up with the IDO. Any final words, guys?
No, thanks for listening, everybody. Hope you guys have a great weekend. Looking forward to this next few months.
Thank you, May. Thank you, Joey and Patrick. Thank you, everybody, for listening. And we'll be in touch with a lot of other exciting announcements and events coming soon. Take care.
Thank you so much.